All right, so Steamboat and Stunning Steve prepare for yet another battle, this time for the first time, Brain. Steamboat is going to be the U.S. Heavyweight Champion tomorrow night. Stunning Steve will be the challenger. But in this matchup, Gary Taylor has a chance of facing Stunning Steve Austin.
But it'll be different rules. This time, Steamboat won't have everything going for him. He won't have the disqualification clause like Stunning Steve had, where if he lost, if he was disqualified, he could lose the belt. Let Steamboat do the same thing. Let him say, hey, if I get disqualified, I'll lose the belt. But no, he's not man enough.
Well, it's different because, no, the disqualification rule is not waived. However, the fact that Stunning Steve is not the U.S. heavyweight champion here means he has to wrestle offensively, means he doesn't want to get disqualified if he wants to bring the U.S. title back around his waist.
And I'll tell you what I like about Austin. Here's a man who was ripped off. I mean, Steamboat and WCW Bachwin, I think, ripped the man off. What does he do? Comes to the ring with a smile on his face. He's leaving the past behind him. He's going to go forward and become United States champion again. But he's got to watch this guy, Terry Taylor, who is a veteran and a real tough customer. He knows what to do in that ring.
Let's remind you fans, coming up next, Mean Gene recently, as he told us earlier, went to the beach to interview Hulk Hogan, who has a statement to make concerning Fall Brawl. Slap to the face.
You're not going to pull any tricks on Taylor.
Boy, they've been giving Stunning Steve a lot of problems recently.
U.S. Joe! U.S. Joe! The peak goes in the front, pal.
The fans have. They've been calling him the U.S. Chump now that he is no longer the U.S. champ. Terry Taylor, of course, great veteran. Great wrestler, and Stunning Steve with that side headlock. Back to the ropes on the right side. Into the ropes, Terry Taylor with a great hip toss out. Steve kicks him down, though, and now picks him up. Good scoop slam, Clancy. Both feet. Time drag takeover. Drop toe hold. And a reversal.
You want to wrestle? He'll wrestle you.
You're right about that. And, of course, Steamboat is the exact type of wrestler in that he will wrestle you. Knows so many great moves. You know, I mentioned on my Tuesday edition of the... Watch out here, one.
Two. Got him.
I mentioned on the Tuesday edition of the Hotline this past Tuesday, and I appreciate all the fans calling in on Tuesday. I talked about Stunning Steve, and I said, win or lose this match against Steamboat, here's a man, Stunning Steve, who deserves a world title shot. I mean, he is... When he wanted to go after the world television title, he did. He won it. When he wanted to become world tag team champion, he, with Flying Brian, became world tag team champion. He's become U.S. heavyweight champion, but he's never achieved that major world title heavyweight title shot, and he needs to.
Well, has he had a title shot for the world championship? See, what the guy needs, he needs a manager. He needs an agent, someone to go in and talk Nick Bockwinkel's language to him. He needs to go in there and grease his... explain to him
right. Exactly
what's going on here.
Well,
I mean, wind him and dine him a bit. Don't you think Steamboat did? Of course he did. Took him to a luau and everything. Sure.
A luau?
Oh, yeah. A luau. You know what a luau is?
Yes. It's a lot of money just to wind and dine a commission.
Yeah, but look at the money you can make if you become world champion. So you pay for some poi and some pork. Big deal.
Seeing the momentum shifting, rolls out of the ring to slow things down. He complains about Terry Taylor pulling on the tights.
But he didn't enjoy himself at the luau. Just something about seeing Dusty's sister there with that apple in her mouth.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Going around and around in a basement. Nah, not a pretty sight. One of those flowered Texas muumuus and boots. Spurs.
You finish.
Right hand to the face.
And Spurs.
Are you finished yet?
Done.
Into the rope for the far side. An elbow. Could have made a cover there, but decides just to drive the elbow into the side of the head. And that enables Terry Taylor to kick out.
Isn't it amazing with all the pain I have? I'm going to be at ringside with you doing the broadcast. I can show up hurt. Nah, no Hulk Hogan. He's at the beach. He's throwing frisbees.
Two count again.
Tell you what he better be doing. He better get himself a metal detector and start checking the beach for change. Because when Flair's done with him, eventually down the road, he's going to have to find some way to help his income.
I got news for you. Flair's not going to be done with him because Flair is out of here.
No, I'm talking about court-wise. Flair's not done with him. I happen to know Flair's going to have some. And I'm looking into it, too, about some legal help with this matter.
Oh, you are?
Yes, I am. Happened to be in severe pain, but I got it out.
Former world champion Ric Flair, as fans you know, has been suspended from WCW indefinitely. It goes for Sensua Sherry as well. A reversal into the corner. Whoa, the knee. And a roll up. One, two. No, put on the ropes. The referee saw it.
He didn't get you.
Steve thinking he won. Celebrate. One, two.
See? Told you about that, Terry Taylor. You got to watch him.
He almost had an upset win. Steve takes him in. Terry Taylor trying the sunset flip. The referee.
Come on, ref. You can't do that. Count is all you can
one,
do.
One, two, three.
He got it.
Steve gets the win. Stunning Steve with a big win here on WCW Saturday Night. Now making his way over to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow night, exclusively on pay-per-view at Ball Brawl, the War Games, this man, Stunning Steve Austin, is going to be locking up with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, and the United States title is going to be on the line. However, a different story this time out.
Right when Ricky Steamboat got used to being called champ, right when that little mealy-mouthed kid pulled the bag off his head and wasn't ashamed to be Ricky Steamboat Jr., right when he checks the old lady out of the Betty Ford Clinic, along comes Fall Brawl and Double S Austin with a look in his eyes no one's ever seen before. You know Steamboat, he's got the bad shoulder. I'm sure he went to the board of directors like he always does and says, "My arms hurt, Mr. Board of Directors, makes me Mr. Austin, tie one arm behind his back." Ha ha! No can do, Ricky Steamboat. After Fall Brawl, I'm going to turn you back in to what you really have always been. A loser. Did you hear that, Gene? A loser. Oh, Ricky, all night long, I'm coming at you, S.S. Austin, not just to get back what's rightfully mine, but if I put you out of wrestling for good, if you ever get back in the ring again, you'll be a lucky man, and I'll always be the United States champion. Yeah!
We're going to find out, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, exclusively on pay-per-view. Contact your cable company now. It is going to be a barn burner for Saturday night after this timeout here on TBS. Give me a break.